This tutorial is demonstrating the basic use of WiThrottle as a controller through JMRI. I will use the term iPhone to refer to an iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch. There are a few things that have to be done to use WiThrottle, and typically they are a one-time setup. You would need to download JMRI software, the newest version available is preferred, install drivers for your DCC interface, connect the hardware, and adjust JMRI connection preferences for the hardware. We will assume that JMRI is already configured to work with your DCC system. Also, the iPhone needs to connect to the same local network as the JMRI computer. The network does not need to have access to the internet for WiThrottle to work. It is just a connection between the computer and the phone. I'm going to begin by starting Panel Pro. Once it is running, I will go into the Tools menu under the subheading of Throttles and select Start WiThrottle Server. It may take it a few seconds to get the connection started. To make things easier later, I'm going to go to the Panel Pro menu under Preferences and select the WiThrottle heading. Here, I will click on Start Automatically with Application. Now, every time you start this JMRI profile, the server for WiThrottle will also start. After selecting that, I will click on Save. If you are starting JMRI with the Decoder Pro entry, Start WiThrottle is found in the Action menu. I am going to use the full version of WiThrottle for this demo, but the free version, WiThrottle Lite, would work exactly the same. When the app is opened, it begins to search for the WiThrottle server that JMRI is broadcasting. It should find the service, and the app will connect to it automatically. The WiThrottle window of JMRI will show a list of all connected iPhones and the addresses they are controlling. The screen that we are presented with is the address screen. There are four primary controls: keypad field to enter an address numerically, set to request the address from the DCC system, release to tell the DCC system that we are done controlling that address, recents and roster to select a previously used address or one that is in the roster of JMRI. At the bottom is a tab bar. This is the main navigation of the screens in the app and is present on nearly every screen. I will begin by tapping the keypad area and entering 4412. You would enter an appropriate address for your decoder and then set. If the DCC system approves the request, the address will appear in the top left box on a green background. This address will also appear in the JMRI WiThrottle window. This iPhone is now controlling that address. Select Throttle on the tab bar to switch to the control screen. This throttle layout is referred to as a road throttle. At the top of the screen is a direction control, which shows that the decoder is at idle and the direction is set forward. Tapping idle while moving will send an idle command to the decoder. On the left is a speed control area. Any touch in this area will affect a speed change. The handle is just an indicator. It will move proportionately to the speed step and also display it numerically. Sliding a finger toward the top of the screen will increase speed. Downward will decrease. The speed can also be changed one step at a time by tapping the top half to increase or bottom half to decrease. This area is the function pane, which slides to reveal functions up to F28. The buttons will highlight to indicate a function that is on. The stop button sends an emergency stop command to the decoder controlled by this throttle. It should stop the loco, ignoring any momentum programmed into the decoder. This area indicates the address selected for this throttle. It will also take you to the address selection screen. Let's go to the settings screen and take a look at some of our options. We can select different layouts for the throttle screen, adjust how fast the throttle changes value in relation to finger movement on a throttle screen, Select words or icons to indicate the direction of travel. Send an idle command immediately if an event prevents speed control. This could be leaving the throttle screen or receiving a phone call. With it off, it will delay sending the idle command. This will quiet the clicks that are made by the throttle screen. This item, typically leave this at release. This shows the connection information and allows selection of a different server if more than one is in use. Allow the iPhone to connect automatically to a JMRI server. If turned off, you will have to enter the connection information manually. The name of this device as displayed in JMRI. It can be changed here or left to the default name that is already set for the device. Let's change to a yard throttle. The main difference is that the speed control handles forward and reverse with a center idle position. When traveling in one direction, the slide will stop at the center before crossing to the other direction. Contact with the screen has to stop before it will cross the center. Tapping on the speed control will work the same as road throttle, changing one step at a time. Hopefully this gave you a good feel for the basic features of WiThrottle. Thank you very much for watching, and remember, whatever you do with model railroading, have fun!